happened a few weeks ago.
It was a cozy night. We're doing just roasting chicken
roasting
and having
chicken.
And it was just an amazing surprise. It was so sweet and natural and very romantic. As a matter of fact, I could barely let you finish proposing. I was like, can I say yes now?
She didn't even let me finish. Yes, we first met. We were introduced actually by a mutual friend who
we should protect her privacy
protect
and not
her privacy,
reveal
yeah.
too much of that.
And but it was literally, it was through her. And then we met once and then twice back to back, two dates in London last July.
Yeah.
Was, I think, about 3, maybe 4 weeks later that I managed to persuade her to come and join me in Botswana.
Some of that scrutiny was centered around your ethnicity, Megan. When you realized that, what did you think?
Of course, it's disheartening. You know, it's a shame that that is the climate in this world, to focus that much on that, or that that would be discriminatory in that sense. But I think, you know, at the end of the day, I'm really just proud of who I am and where I come from. And we have never put any focus on that. We've just focused on who we are as a couple.
The ring is obviously yellow gold, because that's her favorite. And the main stone itself, I sourced from Botswana. And the little diamonds either side are from my mother's jewelry collection. I think she would be over the moon, jumping up and down, you know, so excited for me. But then, as I said, we'd have probably been best friends with Megan's.